I want to show you the mug I'm using to drink water right now. I think you can see it. I hate the morn dust, which is Monday in Skyrim. So it's a Skyrim mug. And well, I'm just drinking water right now to help my throat during this video. Let's hope the mug doesn't make too much noise on the table. I think that was pretty good. Alright. So the first game I got was Demon's Souls. Now, I've heard a lot about this series. Well, as you can see, I found it for pretty cheap. But there, I have a few things to say about this first. I actually own Dark Souls. Although I think on the Xbox, sadly. But I have Dark Souls, which I haven't played. And I actually had Demon's Souls before on my PlayStation 3 because it was free on PlayStation Network. Or PlayStation Plus, but I saw this game and I couldn't pass up having a physical copy, which is why I bought it. But there's also another reason I bought it. This game and the next one that I will show were bought at a local used video game store, and when I bought them, they had a sale that if you bought a video game that was worth $10, as you can see here, you could get another $10 game for free. So pretty much you are getting two games for the price of one. So I was actually buying the next game, and while I was looking for a second game to get, I found this. So since it was technically free, it was a no-brainer for me that I had to get this. That way I could save space on my PlayStation 3 and also just have a physical copy of this. So, I guess we could go inside. The disc is here. There is no manual, sadly. This is just a bill to make sure that I can bring it back if it doesn't work, which it does work. I don't know why I'm keeping it, but you never know. So I really am looking forward to playing this series at some point. I don't know when that will happen, but I do want to play it sometime. There's just other things I want to do before I get to this game. So, that was Demon's Souls for the PlayStation 3. By the way, this thing here is something that is put under a decoration we have on the table. But because the table is so not exactly shiny, well, I guess shiny, because that reflects light and you could see everything, including the camera, on the table, I figured I would put this in the middle of the view. That way it wouldn't be too distracting. Anyways, the game I bought with Demon's Souls, like I said, I haven't played it. I do want to play it. It is Dragon Ball Z First Limit, or Dragon Ball Basuto Limito. I like that they kept the Japanese writing on it too. I think it's pretty cool. This is an old PlayStation 3 game, which means that sadly doesn't have any trophy. most of the games are both in English and French. So I don't know if people would like me to read it both in English and French. That way you get some more whispering in two languages. Let's see if Demon Souls have both French and English. It does not. Wait. No, it doesn't. Sometimes it's like all written, the whole text in one paragraph down there. I'm not sure why it doesn't have English. It's kind of weird. Maybe because it's a game of the year thing. I don't know. I would try to read them, but from where I am, it's kind of hard to read it while also staying in the camera. I guess I could try though. I just have to bring my hand a lot closer. Deep beneath the nexus, I think. Is that? Yeah, it is. What a great start. Deep beneath the nexus, the old one has awakened. A mighty demon horde pours into Bolotaria. Sorry if I pronounce some stuff wrong, by the way, especially words from the game. As I said, I haven't played the game, so. Devouring the souls of men, called upon by a maiden in black, you go forth to lift the curse. And it got great ratings by all five of these companies. Revolutionary online play. Leave hints, view the deaths of past players, work cooperatively or invade another's game. Ever-changing world. Watch the world around you shift according to the actions of you and your fellow players on the PlayStation Network. Different enemies, items, and events may trigger, leading to very different consequences. Yep, that was Demon's Souls. I guess then I will read the one for Dragon Ball Z first, Limit 2. Destiny is about to be decided. The next generation of Dragon Ball Z fighting. Heroic battles of good versus evil, powered by explosive energy and raw emotion, lie ahead. Enter the ring and enter yourself against the legendary fighters from the Dragon Ball Z universe. Experience lightning fast, action-packed, cinematic battle sequences. Dramatic visuals that blur the line between the gameplay and the anime series. Battle online and match your skills against other opponents. I need a sip of water. So, should I read the French? I guess I will, and you guys can let me know whether or not you want me to keep doing this or not. I just have to say that, like I said earlier, I'm from Quebec, not from France. So my French is a lot different than the regular French from France. So, you know, if you're learning French and you can't really understand what I'm saying, don't worry. It's not because you're bad or anything. It's just because I speak a different French than France's French. Although, really, I'm just reading what is written, so word-wise, it won't really be different. But maybe the way I pronounce it will be. Anyways. Un destin sur le point d'être tracé. La future génération des combattants Dragon Ball Z débat visuel de mise en scène qui brouille la frontière entre le jeu et la série animée. Combat en ligne et mesure de capacité à celle d'autres adversaires. That actually didn't sound pretty good. I'm not used to whispering in French, let's just say that. But yeah, let's look on the inside and see if everything is there. So you've got the disc here, and there's actually a full color manual, which is pretty cool. So that was the second PlayStation 3 game. Now the third one, if you have been following my channel for a little bit, not too long though, you all know what this game is. So I will go straight to it. Tales of Xillia 2, or Tales of Xillia, however you want to say it. So the reason you would know this if you've been following me is because of my unboxing of the collector's edition of this game. But yes, that means I have not played the game yet. You may be wondering why. Well, I will tell you why. Before making this channel, I had a Let's Play channel on which I did a Let's Play of Tales of Xillia, the first game. I had to stop making videos on that channel because now that I work in the morning, I don't really have time to make a lot of videos. And when I was doing those videos, I worked in the evening from 3 to 11 p.m. So in the morning, when my mother was at work, well, I was able to record videos, but now that I work in the morning, when I get back from work, she's almost back too, so I don't really have time to record videos. But I really want to start making videos again. So, if I can find a job working in the evening again, I will definitely start back making those Let's Play videos. And when I do that, I would really like to do a Let's Play of this game to start back, since it's also going back to the roots of my channel. So that's why I have not played the game yet. I'm waiting a little bit to see if I can manage to make videos of it. But if I can't, I will definitely play it on my own at some point. Choice. Ludger Kresnik, a young man with a zest for cooking, lives with his older brother Julius and cat Rollo in the world of Olympias. On his way to his first day at work for a local cafeteria, Ludger runs into a young girl named Marta. And the two soon become involved in an accident that will change both of their lives forever. An enhanced real-time battle experience. Create friendships with new and returning allies. See, this is what I meant. Here, there's a little paragraph in French that just translates the whole directement impliqués dans un accident qui changera jamais le cours de leur vie. Now for the two little things here. Bataille en temps réel améliorée. Noé de sa métier avec de nouveaux ou d'anciens alliés. And the last thing is just theme song, Song for You by Ayumi Hamasaki. And by the way, I realize that you probably cannot read any of this, but well, my camera is a picture camera, so it doesn't autofocus, so I can't like go closer to show you. You won't see anything. Yep. So, Tales of Xillia 2. There's a full cover manual with the disc, and also behind. Racing to new heights with the all-new glider. Atteignez de nouveaux sommets grâce à de nouveaux cartes planeurs. Propel past opponents on wild new courses. Propulsez-vous au premier rang dans de nouvelles pistes délirantes. It's hard to see when it's that small. Explore new ways to play online and compete in 8-player worldwide matches. Explorer de nouvelles façons de jouer en ligne et participer à des courses mondiales de 8 joueurs. Unique card parts and customize your ride. Déverrouiller d'unique pièce de carte. How would you even say card in French? Carte? I don't know. It's definitely like France. France is French. So I'm just gonna say it in English anyways. Déverrouiller d'unique pièce de carte. choisissez votre véhicule. New items, nouveaux objets. Fire flower, the leaf of the seven, which gives you one of every item. But yes, it's a great game if you like Mario Kart. Oh, please open. Really? Well, I was trying to did not make too much noise, but that didn't happen. So yeah, here we have a little manual. And then we have another one for the French one. And yes, I do have the cartridge. It's just in my 3DS case. That way it goes around with me. So if I want to play it, I just switch the game. It's not a bad game at all. It's really fun to play with friends. With download play. Well, I guess they don't have to have download. It doesn't have to be through download play, but it's still pretty fun. This Mario Party never stops. I'm sure Mario Party qui ne s'arrête jamais. You're invited to party your way across 7 all new game boards. Anywhere you go, it's a whole new way to Mario Party. Vous êtes cordialement invité à venir faire la fête sur 7 nouveaux plateaux de jeu. Peu importe où vous vous trouvez, une toute nouvelle façon de vous amuser avec Mario Party. 4 players can share one game card. 4 joueurs peuvent partager une carte. Master 80 all new mini games. Maîtriser 80 nouveaux mini jeux. I guess it's showing 10 mini games. A Clement Cube. A Chromato Cube. What the hell kind of French name is that? Sometimes translations are always. Well, sometimes the translations are really weird. Card Bone. Okay, yeah, it's because usually they're. Buns, so you can't exactly translate bun, but yeah, Garden of Eden, Mauvaise Graine, Slow Glide, Descente dans les Gorges, Thanks a Lot, Bataille de plein dé, No Traction Action, Glissodrome, Buzz of Fuzzy, Zero Zeborif, Choicest Voice, Voix de tête de spectacle, Chain Jumps, L'Avalanche, La Charge du Poulouf, Three House, Trion en Syrie, Kagumba, Kumba à Coco. This is really weird. But hey, so the game is. Actually, the reason I bought it is because when I went to Otakathon, the pronounce dyskaya or dyskeia, but I'm gonna go with dyskeia. Dyskeia 3, absence of detention. This is a remake of dyskeia 3, absence of justice on the PlayStation 3, and it includes all the DLC. This is actually the first game I play in this series, so I didn't really know what to expect other than a game like Fire Emblem, except on steroids, pretty much. And I have to say, this is really, really true. I really love this game. At first it was hard, I didn't really understand much on how the game works. And now I've played it for about 80 hours. Well, maybe not. Probably a lot of that was the Vita standing still with me not touching it because I was doing other things. So let's just say about 60 to 70 hours. I've beaten the main game. And once you beat the main game, wow, there's so much post-game content. There's a ton of extra map, a ton of extra game type, a lot of characters to gain. You can even gain the final boss as an ally. And it's really crazy how much content there is. I think I will try to get the Platinum Trophy, which if you're not familiar with PlayStation Network and trophies, Platinum Trophy is a trophy you get for getting every single trophy. Trophies being the same as achievements on Xbox 360 and Xbox One. So, right, yeah, I've got 30-ish trophies right now, I think, and there's 50-something. It takes a long time, because if you don't know this game, the max level is level 9999. And while there is no trophy for reaching that level, you pretty much need to reach it if you want to get some of those achievements. Two of my guys, the main character Mao and a character I have created, are a little over level 5000. And there's also a mage that I've created, or I guess a skull, as they're called, but they're mages. Is over level 4000, and I'm using these three guys to do most of the post-game stuff, at least what I can do without grinding more than that. But even the grinding isn't that hard. It didn't take more than a few hours to get there, because there's a particular level that is just set up perfectly for grinding. But yes, I'm really, really enjoying this game. And if you like strategy turn-based games with a lot of grinding and a lot of cliche in the story, because this is a parody game as far as story goes, it also breaks the fourth wall a lot. But if you like all of that stuff, I really recommend trying this game out. And maybe like me, you will get up to it. The game is really niche, however you pronounce that word. It's not for all audiences. Not everyone is gonna like this game. But if you're interested in that kind of stuff, it's really worth it. After I beat, or not beat because I've beaten it, but after I get the Platinum Trophy for this game, I might try to get one of the most recent ones. So maybe Disgaea 4, or maybe Disgaea D2, although that's a sequel to the first Disgaea, I think. So I would probably have to play the previous one first, but anyways. Evil Academy is back in session. Get ready for millions of hours of detention-free mayhem. because most of the time I play with the sound off. Histoire supplémentaire de nouveaux chapitres exclusifs avec les nouveaux personnages Stella et Rutile. Fighting your bosses. What are Fuka and Desko doing here? Combat de nouveaux boss. Fuka and Desko, ils font quoi ici? Also, there's a lot of characters that are returning from previous games, but since I haven't played those games, I don't really know of them. Insane customizability. Create unique characters with new job-specific special skills. Et plus de pouvoir, le nouveau sort du nouveau Terra amène des apparitions d'artistes invités et encore plus de dégâts. Which totally does not mean the same thing, by the way. But yes, this game is amazing. I really don't know what to say about that. What else to say about it? It's an amazing game, and if you're into that kind of game, I really recommend trying it. Also, if you've never seen the inside of a PlayStation Vita case, it's pretty damn empty. There's usually no manual, and the cartridge is this, you know, this size. So, yeah. So, this is the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.